Yeah, I don't know what's up with this light. Really, it's like divine light just coming down. I don't know. I tried everything, but looks like I'm gonna have to stick with it in this video. But anyway, you can see I'm in my interview clothes. I just came back from my interview with New York City Teaching Fellows, the program where pretty much as long as you haven't taken two or more credits of education, and as long as you don't have teaching experience, you can apply to become a teacher in a very high need field. Those high needs fields for this year being science, math, and special education. I applied for the special education program, and I mean, seeing as that one is the one I'm most qualified for, I have a bachelor's in social work. So, doing this, becoming a special education teacher, would be a total career shift for me. But the opportunity sounds really great. Let me get out of this jacket. Actually, before I, because it is hot in here. This is a really cool jacket, actually, that I got 4 days ago, because I was preparing for an interview. I think it was 4 days ago. Up in the Bronx, there is this organization called Lift the Bronx, and I did an interview there yesterday. And Lift the Bronx is really cool. It helps people living in poverty get out of that poverty by using a network of volunteers. That if I get hired, I would be the third site coordinators. They already have two site coordinators. The second one got hired like 7 months ago, and I would know next week if I get hired or not. I did really, really good in the interview yesterday. I think it's the best I've ever done, not counting the one I'm going to talk about in this video, which is the New York City Teaching Fellows. This one, it's an interesting thing how it turned out today. But yeah, the Bronx job. I definitely did amazing in the interview. I did really, really good. And I just don't know what's going to happen with that one. They said they'll get back to me a week later. So next week, I'll know if I get that job or not. Hopefully, yes. But it is an AmeriCorps position, so I get paid extremely, extremely low. But it is career building. As me, as a social work major, if I get this position, it'd be really awesome. So I'm definitely, definitely looking forward to that. But yeah, I got this jacket for that because I was having to use this traditional, like, just regular jacket over my suit, which never felt right. It never felt like a professional look. So I went all over my neighborhood to find like a trench coat kind of deal, one that goes like really long, but kind of looks kind of professional. If you're in New York City, if you ever go to like Harlem area, like 125th Street, and you see people walking around in their business suits, and it's really cold winter time. You see a lot of people in those trench coats, and I was hoping to find that, but boy, trying to find stores with that kind of trench coat jacket was hard to find. I eventually found a place that sells suits, like business suits. I went in there. It's called Portobello 40. Went in there. I think there was this kind of, I don't know what the ethnicity or what language he speaks, but his English is very accented, probably Eastern European or something like that. He saw me browsing around and he really helped me out with some great deals. This jacket right here cost me $50. This overall suit package here cost me $80, and now I'm advertising for that place. So that's done. Today was the New York City Teaching Fellows event, and I have to say it's pretty much the most rigorous interview process I've ever completed. Maybe that's because I haven't really applied for a fellowship program like this, but New York City Teaching Fellows is really competitive. I had to apply first. They have a whole application program, and most of it's pretty basic. You put in your information like name, your basic info, where you live. You submit your educational background, your work background, your volunteer background, all that stuff. You put your resume in. The three most thing the thing that's really sticks out are the essays that you have to write. They give you three questions. I mean, depending on what you're applying for, are you applying to be a math teacher, a science teacher, or a special education teacher? For special education teacher, the questions were pretty much, well, the first general question is what makes you want to become a teacher, right? And then the second one is kind of, do you believe that, if I remember correctly, that all students in a high need environment can achieve high academic performance, and if so, why? What are the good qualities of a special education teacher that enable that, right, to happen? And then the third one was pretty much describe your experiences with special needs population and how you can, how you think your skills that you have accrued over time can, you know, help educate and empower that population. Not those exact words, but those are the questions that they ask for. And I applied like, what, like a week and a half ago? No, actually longer than, like 2 weeks ago. I applied 2 weeks ago in Tennessee, right before leaving Tennessee. Then I came to New York, and it, like 2 days after I came to New York, I got this email saying, congratulations, you advanced to the next stage. You're invited to schedule for an interview. I was really surprised because I thought I was going to have to wait a month for that, but apparently I didn't even have to wait a week. So I got accepted. Apparently I must have wrote pretty good essays, I think. I'm not sure how competitive that application process is. But the interview I went is very, very competitive. So I went. The first thing we do is we take a math test. It's 30 minutes, 23 math questions. Pretty basic stuff, I thought. Not some are tricky. Some were tricky. Some were like, you know, a teacher gave the students this math problem, right? And the teacher expected this method to get this solution. And then you get three questions. But these students came up with these approaches. Are these approaches to the solution acceptable or not? Yes or no? And you click them on. Those were fairly simple. The one deceptive one was there was this fraction question that's like, it got me at first, but then I was like, wait a minute. That's, you know, that's not right. So I got there. I was like, I know what you're up to kind of thing, and then solved it. So the math test, pretty easy stuff. And then after that is the trickier parts. It's where five of us or six of us, five of us, I believe. Five of us in a single classroom. And it was kind of disappointing to me, well, the group, because I got to become, like, pretty talkative with this one girl. I don't know if it's right to call her a girl because she's probably a woman now, like, her age-wise, but I call her a girl. Anyway, this girl, you know, pretty good talkative, and you're talking a bit, and then it turns out this guy comes out and he's like, oh, you know, she says her name to the selector, one of the staff members, and she's like, oh, your name is Ebony. And he's like, yeah, oh, they've been looking for you down there. They switched you. So she went to another session, and that was kind of disappointing, but because, you know, she was cool. But that aside, the group thing is the first thing that starts off is the teaching sample that we prepare. So we prepare a 5-minute lesson plan with other candidates as pretending to be students. So we teach a class, right? That is our kind of like a sample teaching class. I didn't do that quite of a good job, I think, but I think overall mine was really well structured. I just thought to do a math topic and in high school because I think I didn't want to do a too simple one. At first, I originally planned to do my topic was originally planned to be how to subtract when the subtracting number, the number you're subtracting from, is less than the number that you are subtracting. And, you know, in the single-digit column, but in the first-digit column, you know, it's a bigger number overall. But, for example, 13 minus 8, you know, 3 is smaller than 8, right? How do you subtract that? That's what I was planning to do, but then I thought, you know what, that's way too simple. I thought to do that because I have a creative way of solving of 13 minus 8. I have a really creative way, which is, you have 8, right, and you have 3. Well, 10 minus 8 is 2. Add that to 3, you get 5. 13 minus 8 is 5. That's a pretty creative way, I thought. So maybe thinking of a creative way to solve a problem would be a really cool way. But then I thought, you know, that's way too simple. You know, that's way too simple of a topic to do. So I actually, my topic ended up being geometry with algebra. So determining the formula for a line when you know the slope and y-intercept. That was my topic. And the good, you know, after learning a lot about New York City teaching sample, I learned that the one thing they're really looking for is the objective, the aim, and to have a do now assignment in order to make sure the kids, the students, review what they learned the previous session and then continue to learn the next session and meet that objective. So I prepared all that. Starting, the structure was really great. I just kind of fumbled a, I was a little, I think a little bit too nervous. So I even called out, one time I was like, I called out one person to say, you know, hey, Marina, so when you have this slope and when you have this intercept and you have this formula, what would you put in for M? And then she answered. And then what would you put in for B, Y-intercept? And then she said the answer. I was like, that's great. Except her name was not Marina. Her name was something else, like Marimi. So yeah, totally missaid someone's name in that lesson. So that's one mistake I had there. Another mistake is, these are little mistakes. The overall mistake probably was that I wasn't that engaging or interesting to the group. And I could have done a lot more for that. So I think I kind of regret that. Another mistake is actually the problem I got wrong. I said something to the effect of, you know, the sample problem that I started with, you know, so the formula for determining the slope is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. And, you know, that's a, you know, if you took basic geometry, that's basic stuff. And I had the guy kind of, he gave me an incorrect answer, which is okay. So I just said, you know, how did you get that answer? But then he just asked me, what's the answer? And, throughout that process, I just asked him, you know, what is this divided by this? And he said 6. 12 divided by 3, 6. And in that instant, 12 divided by 3, 6. I was just like, yes, that's correct. And I went through the lesson plan with that. But no, 12 divided by 3 is not 6, it's 4. And I knew before going into the interview that the slope would be 4. I would have the lesson plan with the slope meaning 4. So, yeah, I did the lesson plan with very incorrect math calculations. But, you know, whatever. The objective was to be able to learn the y-intercept and what that does for the line equation. So, objective, I got that down. I didn't have enough time to get feedback to test the audience's knowledge. So that was one thing. But I did finish it off really good. I finished it up with saying, you know, I gave them a homework assignment, which no one did in the group. I was the only person to give a homework and do now assignment and do the aim on the board. The other people were really creative with their lesson plans, but I was the only one to have that structure, which I think is important. After I read about all the teaching samples, it's good to have structure. And mine had structure. So the last thing was, I had my last problem. I mentioned that from the lesson you learned today will not be sufficient for you to solve the last sample problem on your homework assignment. The homework assignment, the last problem indicates that you have the slope and you have a point, but you don't know the y-intercept. How do you determine the equation of a line? And I told them, you know, from what we learned today, you will not be able to solve this problem, but I want you to go home. Of course, they won't go home and solve it because this is mock, you know, this is pretend sample, like teaching session. But pretty much, I want you to go home and think about how to solve this problem. And tomorrow, we are going to learn exactly that. Next session will be about that. So that was kind of how I linked it to the next teaching session, which is it's recommended. You know, I pretty much did everything that was recommended from everyone who went there to do this assignment. So, you know, it was okay. It wasn't as good as I wanted it to be. I still feel kind of, insecure about how I did that one. After that is group discussion, and this one I think I did the worst on, just because you have two scenarios. Each scenario you're given 15 minutes to talk about with the group, you know, these hypothetical situations that you talk about with the group, like how you would approach the situations that's happening. So pretty much what's happening in the situation is your classroom, half the class is failing. Their grades are falling down, and there's three specific kids that are having three specific problems, and you want to know what you can do for these three children. The group discusses, comes up with ideas, comes up with different approaches to undertake and stuff like that. And the two evaluators, they don't contribute anything to the discussion. They just sit behind us and watch how we interact and how we discuss it. And then after that, there's two questions, writing samples. There's two questions regarding these three scenarios we talked about, and we're given 15 minutes total to answer in writing sample the two questions. So already that's a lot. That's like a 2-hour process right there. And then each person is given a chance to do a 30-minute personal interview. So I, again, I said the group interview, the writing sample, I don't feel so hot on. I don't think I did that good of a job on that. But freaking A, the personal interview, I freaking nailed that shit. I did so good, I think. I mean, they asked a lot of questions, and I really, really answered well. I think one thing that really makes me stand out in this interview compared to perhaps other candidates is that I am a social work major, so I really approach things with the social work mentality. And I've had a lot of one-on-one tutoring experiences, and I had a lot of experiences with dealing with special needs clients. My internship was on helping clients living with HIV and AIDS, helping clients who are homeless, who are addicted to substances, you know, all these separate issues that are very, very special need. Of course, all the clients that I dealt with in my previous internships were kind of not students. They were, like, you know, median age would be 40, 45, 50. All my clients were of that age, very high age group. None of them were students. And in my educational field, the only time I really did group setting was in just in the group setting was with, like, being a teacher's aide to an after-school program. In high school, I was, my community service, my eighth period, my community service period, I'm surprised I actually had that. I hardly remember that. But my eighth period was going to this elementary school in the neighborhood and being a fourth grade teacher's aide, and also helping out the librarian. So on Wednesdays, I would be with the librarian, helping the librarian. Monday, Tuesdays, and Thursdays and Fridays, I would be with the fourth grade teachers and helping them with PE, teaching science, teaching math. So that's really my educational experience, tutoring and teacher's aide and stuff of that nature. So with that background, what really makes me stand out is my one-on-one empathy communication methods. You know, starting with where the person is at, respecting that person, earning that trust of a person, building a relationship. And that was my main line, that main argument, you know, that teaching is more than about, you know, getting this knowledge, this content to another person. You know, it's not just, you know, sharing this encyclopedia knowledge. You know, to do that, you can just read stuff. You can go to an encyclopedia, get some information. Teaching is more than that, I think. And I think I really, that was my overall theme in the interview. And I think that's what really made me do a lot better, using personal examples, of course, of my experiences, using great theory, and, you know, just using what I think I know to answer the questions. And that is that teaching is building a relationship. It's to inspire, it's to empower, it's to motivate the students into achieving a potential that they may not even realize that they have, but I know that they're capable of achieving. And that's really, I actually said something like that in the first part of the interview, something like that. So the interview, I did, I think for all the shortcomings I had in the group activity and the writing sample, which I kind of ran out of time on the second question, I kind of wrote it like a sentence, it finished, but then I didn't get to like totally complete the writing sample. But so the shortcomings of all that activities, I think, was compensated for my pretty much ass kicking in the personal interview. I mean, I really feel that I did really, really well. This is one of the first times after I did an interview where I feel like I don't think I could have done anything better or said anything better or in a manner I could have done better. I was really well composed. Because I remember last time I was in New York, I interviewed for this position. Trying to remember. It was in Brooklyn Community Services. It was being a wellness coordinator. Which is helping to develop jobs and job training and stuff like that. That position, I said the things right, but my posture was completely off base because I was clicking my pen, because I was nervous, I was being fidgety. This one, I think I was well composed, I was very professional, and this tie, man, my dad's tie is fucking badass. Like, I love this tie. But yeah, I looked good, I think. Pretty much, I don't have too much of, yeah. I mean, don't look too bad, I think. So, I looked good, I was professional, I did really good in the interview. So, really, I'm hoping for this one to be well. But this one is a New York City Teaching Fellows, is a very arduous process. I mean, That whole interview process was 4.5 hours. I got out at like 8:50. I went into the thing at 3:40. So, yeah, very rigorous. I mean, it's just so much stuff they're looking for. They test you on so much different stuff, and I'm just glad I made through that. Before I end talking about the interview, actually, the important thing was I actually did plan out what questions I wanted to ask after she asked me all the questions. It was actually, the interview, like, the questions she asked me were not that many, I felt. There were a lot of hypothetical. There was even a role play where she acted as a, she was like, okay, we're going to do a role play. I'm going to be a 7th grade student, and you're going to be the teacher. And perhaps, you know, I come to you and I say that Matt, it's too hard for me and I can't do it anymore. What would you do? That was the role play, which was really interesting. And I think I did pretty good on that one. And even got her role-playing self to consider, you know, turning to her peers. You know, I said, well, have you considered talking to, you know, other friends about your problem that you're having with math if it's too hard of a subject? Are they having problems with us as well? And her role-playing, she kind of stammered a bit and she said, well, I haven't considered about that. And I was like, well, you know, that's great. I mean, it is definitely something to consider about, because your peers are going through the same things as you. And if perhaps maybe they're struggling really hard too, and if that's help is not, support is not enough, you also could seek support from, and this is me just pretending that the school has this, you could also get support from the tutoring program that we have, or the after-school program that we have. I mean, have you considered tutoring? And then that's when she said, okay, I think, yeah, that's a good role play right there. And then she quit, and then she asked another question. So, interview session, I think, really went well. After she asked questions, the questions I asked were pretty specific. I'm trying to remember what I asked. Let's see. I first asked about the process of New York City teaching, the procedure, what happens next, pretty much. There is this April intensive program, and I asked her about that, what you do in there, and it's pretty much, and I asked her if we get approved for this program, do we also get approved for that, and she said it's optional, and anyone who gets exception to program can actually go indeed be in that program, and what that program is pretty much shadowing a teacher in the classroom, even assisting the teacher in some classrooms and getting a hands-on experience before moving on to the training. And the training is pretty much kind of getting your master's kind of deal in the classroom, and that's what she explained all this to me, which was really nice. And then the last final question I asked was just pretty much a hypothetical, pretty much basic question about teaching is, actually, there was a question I asked before that. The question I asked before that is, special education, like, how is it different in, it wasn't in the formal question, it was more like, now, I said in my application that I don't really have too much of a preference for high school special education or elementary education, because I'm really confident and willing to do either one, and I'd be really grateful to do that one. But I'm assuming there's a difference between the kind of two levels of education, right? That's kind of questioned it. And she's like, certainly, and then she told me a lot of the variations of special educations in grade levels. So that was the second to last question I asked. The last question I asked, I said, well, okay, thank you so much. And I have one last question to ask. And what I want to ask is pretty much if I just want to know how by the letter you have to be with the teaching materials, because I do expect that there are teaching materials from the school state board that you have to teach with. How by the letter do you have to be? Do you have a lot of open, like, freedom to teach with your own creative approaches? And she said from her experience that she does. And, you know, that's how I ended the interview. And it was, like I said, personal interview-wise, I think I'm really getting better and better at this one-on-one, or even three-on-one, as long as it's kind of an interview. I think I'm getting better, and I think part of the reason is because I think I have you guys, YouTube, to thank. You know, talking in front of the camera has really, I think, over the time, if I look at my videos throughout time, I think I've kind of improved. If I look at, like, one of my earliest videos, I see me saying, you know, da-da-da-da-da, you know, and pauses a lot. A lot of you knows, a lot of kind of, you know, but like that, just like that. It still happens. But definitely speaking in front of the camera has helped. And I think interviewing is one of those things. The more you do it, the better you get at it. And I'm surprisingly, after yesterday, I've really come to just not get sick of them, because I was getting like kind of discouraged and stuff. Like before I came, you know, like a month before in New York, I was applying a lot and interviews happened. And I just was like, you know, I don't think I'm cut out for this interview stuff. And now I'm doing it. And I feel good. You know, I want to look good, do good, and just do interview. And even if I don't get these two job positions, I know there are so many job positions open out there. And I just got to keep applying, keep on trying. And I don't want to, you know, have this spirit down. So I think that's really cool. For all you, you know, anyone who's watching this, who's a job seeker, searching for jobs, you know, don't lose hope. You know, keep at it, I think. I think it's a very hard time to be in, but don't let the times get you down. Sometimes the situation is just how it is. But the more you do it, the more you improve, and just always be try to prepare more, I think. I think now I realize that how much I need to prepare more. Because this one, these two interviews, I really prepared about what will they ask me and how will I answer. And I rehearsed that a lot. I talked to myself in the mirror a lot to prepare for this. And, you know, and also even having a MacBook computer with the camera helped too, because I can record myself and judge. After I record, I look at that video and I said, you know, I can judge my performance by the recording. And I think that's really important. And, you know, I'm just going to keep on trying. I'm going to keep my spirits up. And that's my video. If you guys enjoyed it.